benefits of PRINCE2, based on best practice and governance. It can be tailored to organizational needs and also the complexity of the project. Now, we've already touched on these on the way through to this point. It can be applied to any type of project. It has a common language. You understand PRINCE2 when you hear it, when you see it. It ensures focus on viability of the project. It gives you start points at which you can assess viability, at which point you can also say, this doesn't make sense. It ensures that you get correct stakeholder involvement. It gives you functionality for those stakeholders to actually be involved. It promotes learning from experience. Learning from experience. You learn from previous projects. You actually learn from stages within the current project. You can apply that learning stage by stage. And finally, it's supported by an accredited organizations for expertise. Axelos license trainers to deliver this training. They license training organizations to deliver this training, so you get a standard of quality. PRINCE2 is based on a customer supplier approach. Okay, the organization that commissions a project. Now, this could be corporate, program management, customer. It could be somebody external to your organization. It could be somebody within your organization. But there is a customer of some kind. The supplier is that entity which is going to deliver the output. So person, group, groups, different organizations, whatever. Whatever makes up the structure that you need to deliver the outputs of this particular project. And projects can be standalone, they can be part of a program, they can be part of a wider portfolio. The London 2012 Olympics was widely touted as a massively successful project. It was never a project. It was a massive program within which you had sub-programs, within which you had projects. So the creation of the velodrome, for example, would have had multiple projects all working within a program and probably sub-programs as well. So they do work together. The projects are the delivery mechanism for programs. Okay? Essentially, a customer has a need, a supplier delivers that need. And then the common route to project startup. Coming through feasibility via a mandate into startup. Feasibility, this is what happens at corporate level or at program level. This is where the idea is first mooted. This is what we need to see as an end point. Now let's put together the bare bones of a project mandate and see what happens. So that mandate then leads into a startup. The startup is the first point at which PRINCE2 becomes involved. Okay, the mandate is the trigger to lead into that startup. The startup is where you prepare to use PRINCE2 effectively to deliver the content of that project. We've now reached the end of that first couple of chapters. What you now need to do is read chapters 1 and 2. And then once you've read those and you feel that you've understood them in line with what you've already heard, you then come back and you will have a few questions which are from the PRINCE2 mock exams, so they're live questions, for you to answer to test your understanding. Okay, so welcome back. The fact that you're now back means that you've read chapters 1 and 2, and you're now ready to take the questions. So you will now see questions 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right. Ignore the numbers on the questions, because what has been done here is that questions relevant to these chapters have been drawn from that mock exam. So those numbers on there don't mean anything. You've got 5 questions. Now, the key to answering these questions, notice the multiple choice. multiple choice questions are easy. Because you look at the question, you look at the choices, and normally you can eliminate at least two of them. Get rid of the dross before you start. Okay? Then deal with what's left. Okay? It becomes a toss of the coin, if nothing else. So you've got a 50-50 chance. All right? So answer the questions. You've got a minute for each question, because when you take your live exam, you will have 60 questions in 1 hour. So you have a minute per question. Don't spend 5 minutes on one question. It's only worth one mark. If there's a question that you can't answer, move on. Come back to it afterwards. All right? In this environment, you need to answer all five, but you're not really under time pressure. Try and keep it to a minute per question. But if you have to spend time on one, that's fine in this environment. Next thing you'll encounter is the answers. It tells you which answers are correct, which answers are incorrect. So looking at the questions you've just answered, the first one, the correct answer is A. As one of the minimum requirements, a PRINCE2 project must demonstrate that the project has processes that satisfy the purpose and objectives of the PRINCE2 processes. And it gives you a reference number. That reference number points you to a page in the manual. Okay, B, C and D are all incorrect for the reasons specified on there. The next one, the correct answer is C. PRINCE2 refers to a supplier as the person, group or groups responsible for the supply of the project's specialist projects, or products, sorry. And it points you at reference 2.5. So you've got a chapter 2, you're looking for section 2.5. For the third question, correct answer is B. PRINCE2 promotes learning from project experience and continual improvement in organisations. Reference 1, you'll find that in the first couple of pages. The fourth question. Answer is D. Projects involve a team of people with different skills working together to introduce a change that will impact others outside the team. And that's reference 2.1. Finally, question 5, answer is B. The 6 aspects of project performance to be managed are cost, timescale, scope, quality, risk and benefits, reference 2.3.